So I was recently asked if there was a way in Photos to select all of the photos that do not have a keyword applied. Let me show you what I mean. Here's a sample photos album here. And I've got keywords applied to some of these photos but not others. I can use a Command I and then select a photo and see that there's a keyword applied to this one. There's one to this one, but say not to this one. There's no keyword there at all. Now it's easy to use a smart album to find out something like if the album is not any, then create a smart album with these in it. So this would put all the photos that are not in any album there. But there's no way to do that for keyword. For keyword, you go in there and you can say is or is not a specific keyword. But in order to actually find all the ones that have no keyword applied, you would have to add the plus button, say all, and then continue to add keyword is not, and then every single one. Which isn't that bad if you've got six keywords like I have here, but if you have 600 keywords like you may have in a complex photos album or library that has all your photos in it and you like to add lots of keywords, it's just not possible. So how can you do it? It doesn't seem to be a way. What's even more frustrating is you can go to View, Metadata, Keywords, like I have checked there, and you can actually see this little tag on any photos that have keywords applied, and there's no tag on the ones that don't. So you can actually see them, but there's no way to gather them all together. So you could say maybe have an album that you can then work on applying keywords, or maybe if it's a special project, delete the photos that have no keywords applied to them. But you can do this if you use some scripting. So you know that there's two ways to do scripting on the Mac. One is in the script editor and the other is in Automator. And I'm going to use Automator for this because it will allow me to very easily attach this as a command that appears in Photos. So I'm going to run Automator with Command space, type Automator, and bring up Automator. And I'm going to create something that's a new service. And a service will allow me to add a menu item in Photos that has a link to this script. And I'm going to say choose. So now I've got a new script here that I can start. I'm going to go and say I want this to receive no input, but not just any application. I want this to be something specific that works in Photos. So I'm going to go and select Photos from the list here. Great, no input in Photos. And now I can start to drag and drop selections. So what I want to do is instead of using something built in here in Automator, I'm actually going to type JavaScript. Start typing it here, and you can see that there is a run JavaScript action. I'll put that in and you can see here I can actually type my JavaScript in here which is where we'll put our scripts. So to save some time I'm actually going to copy and paste here. So I'm going to select this and delete it, and the first line of the script is actually going to just define a variable called photos as the application photos. So now we can refer to commands having to do with the Photos app very easily. The second command is going to simply create a new album. So this is called No Keyword Album. It's just a name I chose as a variable inside the script. And it's going to use the photos.make command. And it's going to have two parameters inside of an object here. It's going to say it's going to create a new album. That's the type of thing it's going to create. And the name is going to be No Keywords. So that's what I'm going to call this album. And it will just appear. If I were to run this at this point, it would create an album here that would be called No Keywords, and that's all it will do. So let's test it. And you can see it did it right there. Created this No Keywords album. I'll go in here and I'll delete the album so we can start off fresh. But it's nice to test the script that way. Next we're going to go and start to go through all the photos in the Photos app. So I'm going to create a variable called selected photos, again my name that I chose, and it's going to set to photos.selection with the parentheses there. That's basically going to say select all of the photos that I have selected in the app. This is useful because you don't want to have it automatically assume you want to go through the entire Photos library, but you can easily choose all your photos. Just go to All Photos, Command A, and you have them all selected. Even if you have 100,000 photos, Command A will just select them all. But if you did want to run the script on a small selection, like say all of the photos in a specific album that had no keyword, you can do that as well by going to the album, selecting all just inside that album, and the script will work for that. So that's really handy. So next we're going to loop through all of the photos. So I've done a for loop here. I've created a variable called photo, the lowercase p there, of selected photos. So it's going to basically loop through setting the variable photo to each photo in selected photos. Each time it loops, I want it to grab the keywords inside of the photo. So there I'm using the photo right there, photo.keywords. It's getting all those and putting them in the variable keywords. Next I'm going to check to see if that's null, because if there are no keywords assigned to that photo, then keywords is going to be equal to null. And this is where we want to do something. We're going to use the add command, photos.add, and we're going to take an array, that's what those brackets are, of that one photo and add it to the no keyword album, which is what we created here, that new album called no keywords. And then we're going to simply close this if statement and close the loop. And that's all it needs to do, is it just goes, loops through all the photos, adds any that have keywords equal to null to that new album we created. Now we can test this. I'm going to hit the play button. First let's bring the photos to the front here and bring Automator on top of that, and we'll see what happens when I hit play. And you can see it created that album called No Keywords, and sure enough, if you look in it, there are five photos, and these are indeed the five photos that have no keywords applied to it. So last thing we need to do is save. Now because we've set this up as a service in the Photos app, I hit Command S to save. It'll ask me to name it. So I'm going to call it Create Album with Photos that Have No Keywords, and hit save. Now when I switch over to Albums and I go to Photos, Services, there it is. And I can execute this script, this Automator script here, just by using this. I don't even have to have Automator open. So I can go to Automator here. I can quit because I've saved that. I can now go into Photos and I can do it again. Watch what happens when I do it again, by the way. It's smart enough to actually create an album called No Keywords with the parentheses 1 in it. Now I had nothing selected, so let's try it again. Let's select all these photos, Photos, Services, create them, No Keywords 2, and it has those in there. So I can actually now rename these really easily so that I could say take an album, find all the photos in it that have no keywords, rename that to something, do it in another album or another selection, all that. It's really easy and versatile, and it's all done with just that little bit of scripting.